Conceive, believe, achieve. Shut the fuck up.
Islam Makhachev. Say it, Lewis.
Islam Makhachev.
Oh my God. God, you should be a commentator. Islam Makhachev went out there. I'm just going to say Makhachev. I don't care. Sorry, brother. I do apologize, but you know, Manscaped, number one lawnmower. remember that? That was funny. Yeah, listen. Yeah, man, he was phenomenal. He was absolutely phenomenal. I mean, there's so many things to talk about. Obviously, there's the comparisons to Khabib. He's from Dagestan. And did you see that feature that they ran on Saturday night? If you only saw the main and comment, you might not have saw it.
I didn't see it, no.
Oh, dude, it's mind-blowing. The village that they're from in Dagestan, I mean, it's no wonder they're so good at fighting because it doesn't look like there's much to do. But it's these buildings made out of what look to be just cobblestones, like legit stones, rocks, you know what I mean? And they build them into the side of the mountain. And there's like some little, not streets, but like underground tunnels. It's like going back to Lord of the Rings stuff. They're like hobbits that can wrestle really, really good. And I'm not trying to be disparaging. I'm really not. I was just saying, when you see that and you see just how different life is for them, it's really inspirational to see where they are now and see what Khabib has done. And I was taking over the world of combat sports and one of the biggest stars and all the money he's earned and just how much he gives back to everybody in that village. It's incredible.
Well, there's probably, I mean, when you come from those sort of humble beginnings, I think it's like it's funny you say, it's like, you know, what else is he there to do, right? He, no wonder they're so good at wrestling in an MMA, you know? Like, here, we have all the distractions in the world. I have video games and cable, and I have fucking all these great restaurants. I'm in New York City. It's like, there's so many reasons to be lazy and to not go and like just spend your time doing that. So I completely get that. But when you have that humble beginnings, you have to assume that Khabib doesn't he's been wired differently. I'm assuming he doesn't really give a fuck about flashy cars and jewelry and things the same way that people from other cultures do. Or maybe he does. I don't know. I don't really follow Khabib on social media, but he doesn't seem to be flashy that way.
No, he doesn't. And he doesn't seem to be wrapped up in the celebrity lifestyle either. In fact, Harrington, maybe you can bring the point up. I know it was in the notes, but this was an amazing point. Actually, we'll get to the fight in a second, but seeing as we're talking about Khabib, we'll just stick with this. excuse me. He's such a great teammate and a coach. Obviously, his father passed away, Abdulmanap, and now, if I'm getting this right, they're calling it father's plan. Javier Mendez was in the corner of Islam on Saturday night. And he said, listen, the striking's good. You're doing good with the striking, but just stick with father's plan, which is obviously taking down and smash them to fucking smithereens. You know what I mean? Because on the feet, if you get caught with a shot, you never know. But Islam, after the fight at the post-fight press conference, he said, you don't understand what Khabib does for us. Like, he flies out here. He's retired, but he flies out here for the training camps, trains them all at AKA, puts them up in cars, buys rents a beautiful house for all the team to stay in, doesn't charge them a penny for rent, doesn't charge them for the rental cars or the gas or the food or the supplements, anything they need, he pays for it all himself, and he's just trying to support all his local people and his teammates and his brothers. And I got to say, it's fucking beautiful, man.
That's awesome. And it also, you know, creates an opportunity for them. You know, we talked about this for years. Like, when you get to be at a level where you have a certain amount of success in this sport, you have a lot more advantages. Even, you know, you talk about going to train at the UFC Institute, right? Or just these other things that you didn't even have growing up, right? You sort of see it. And I think young fighters, it's a tough road. You have to really love it in the beginning. There's not a lot of money. You're doing it for the love of the game. You know, you have this bigger vision. Hopefully you become a champion one day. But you're putting a lot, you're investing a lot of your life into it, into sort of an unknown, right? And I think that when you have somebody like Khabib doing that for his guys and his team, it takes away a lot of that worry. Money doesn't solve everything, right? But I think it does help out when you're struggling and you don't know where your future is, to go, you know what, dude, I have this taken care of. I have great training. I have great partners. I have great food, cars. I'm sure that adds a lot to his team.
Yeah. Oh, no, absolutely. As you say, money doesn't buy happiness, but it certainly reduces the stresses and opens doors and makes things a hell of a lot easier. In fact, I remember, because I was always visualizing fighting Anderson Silva for the belt at 185. I did fight him, but not for the belt, not when he was champ. And I always remember thinking, this motherfucker Anderson has been headlining pay-per-views. He's the biggest star in the sport. He's got untold amounts of millions, you know what I mean? And his training camp facilities and the recovery people and the masseuses and the supplements and just the support network that he would have around him is far going to outweigh mine. And I was like, I thought, do I ask for like an extra little bump for the fight? Because I'm going to need, I want to level the playing field a little bit. And Dana would have said, no, fuck off. No, absolutely. When you win the belt, then you get that. He's earned that. And that's just the way it goes, unfortunately. Yeah. Quick side note, just to revisit this, Brian adds, birds can abandon nests if disturbed or harassed, dooming eggs and hatchlings. Less obvious, repeated human visits close to a nest or nesting area can leave a path or a scent trail for predators to follow. So Rebecca was right, you were wrong, and I actually didn't have an opinion either way. Anyway, Islam Makhachev. So, listen, everyone knows about his wrestling, the comparisons to Khabib, the style, the same coaches, same background, all the rest of it. But I thought Thiago Moises would give him a good run. I thought Thiago Moises was possibly a bad stylistic matchup. His striking looked really good last couple of times out against Alexander Hernandez, who's very good, but just hasn't been too successful lately. Moises looked great, and he talked about using footlocks, and I thought that was a really smart approach. But he couldn't get shit going on Saturday night. Makhachev was great on the feet. In fact, he landed more shots. He was the better striker. And the takedowns, he took them with authority. And then when he got on top, I mean, he was so good.
Yeah, and that's something that I guess he said before the fight. He was like, look, I just know I'm on another level from this guy. And it was very obvious. He sort of just walked him down. And, yeah, it was a very, very impressive performance. I was impressed with the striking. I thought he was going to just, you know, take him down. He just seemed to be really in love with throwing kicks, throwing high kicks, like really, you know, just sort of standing in the pocket, trading, throwing hard shots. It was great. He seems very well-rounded. And it was dominant. You know, it was really, really dominant. You said something during the fight about Moises, his back foot was sort of against the cage the whole time, you know, and he just backed up and stayed stationary. And I just think he was really at a loss for what to do. He seemed to be a little bit in a trance because of how good Islam was.
Yeah, well, Islam certainly, obviously, the better fighter. But I do think that, you know, to your point, that kind of affected him a little bit. It was kind of like a deer in the headlights. He's like, oh, shit. You know, he's like, oh, God, what do I do here? He's beating me on all aspects. But the point I was making was he was allowing himself to get backed up to the fence every time. And you're fighting a guy that you know wants to take you down. Being against the fence is the last place you want to be. Number one, if someone's trying to shoot or take you down, you want to be moving. If you're a moving target, you're harder to hit or harder to shoot on. You know, if you move to the side, they're going to shoot on fresh air. But if you're up against the fence, that makes somebody that's a very, very mediocre wrestler makes him a good wrestler. Most of the time when I took people down, it was against the fence because you don't even need to know how to be a wrestler. Remember what we were drilling when you came down to Costa Mesa? I was showing you just go in, you just lower your base, you get your hands around the backside, you pick them up in the air, you put them fucking down. It's easy. Also, with the fence behind you, you can't sprawl, you can't back off, you can't do anything. Whereas on the flip side, the person that you're fighting, if you do anything to trouble them, they've got the entirety of the octagon behind them. So they're clearly in the advantageous position. So was it a rear naked choke? Remind me, I called the fucking fight.
And if I'm not mistaken, Moises was a high level jiu-jitsu guy, right?
Phenomenal jiu-jitsu, very, very high level. Makhachev went out there, defeated Makhachev, beat him very soundly. And I don't know. Is there any negatives you'd say? Because some people, I saw people saying, oh, it was kind of boring, you know, but if you appreciate the finer nuances, the grappling that was on display, that was very, very high level mixed martial arts. I really enjoyed it. I think he's going to have a bright future. He called out Rafael Dos Anjos afterwards. He actually said he was going to call out Tony Ferguson as well, which I thought might've been a better call out, but, who do you want to see him fight next? And Harrington, jump on, give your opinion.
Yeah, please. I'll say, just to answer your other question about whether or not it was a boring fight, I thought that he was very dynamic. I thought he was showing a lot of diversity in everything he was doing, keeping his opponent guessing. And it was really interesting to watch him systematically break the spirit of Moises. Like, you watched it happen. There was a moment where, like, in the third round where he was just like, dude, he wasn't, like, he knew. It was like, this is happening. And, yeah, he probably could have come on a little bit stronger, a little bit earlier, but you can't fault the guy for fighting a perfect fight, wanting to, you know, stretch his legs, get more rounds in, get more cage time in, work on his striking. I mean, if I'm Islam Makhachev, I'm going, that was a damn near perfect fight. And he got the finish after going into the later rounds. That's what you want.
Yeah. Oh, no, of course. That's absolutely what you want. You want the finish. You know, had it been five rounds, maybe there would have been a bit more negative backlash.
All right, Mike, let's take a quick moment and thank Paleo Valley Snacks for supporting today's show. Paleo Valley Snacks makes incredible high-quality beef jerky. And if you're on the go like myself or you, Mr. Bisping, you want a snack that's healthy and easy to carry with you, the Paleo Valley beef sticks are exactly that.